San Diego politics will look much different in 2019.
Several city council members, some surprisingly so, got voted out yesterday, and voters finally approve a stadium plan. We'll see what happens with that. Here to talk about it all, of course, Rick Epps. Rick, good morning, sir. Appreciate it.
Good morning. Good to see you.
Okay, let's talk about this SDSU West.
Yeah.
Prop G versus Prop E with Soccer City. What happened here? Because Prop E, Soccer City, not only did they lose, I mean, they were demolished yesterday.
Yeah, I was surprised that it was that far apart.
Right. What went wrong for them?
You know, it's interesting. Even though their plan seemed more specific in terms of its, you know, what they were going to do and what they're trying to accomplish than the other measure, it was interesting. I think people were really concerned about the corporate interest and what they were concerned about who was going to benefit from what was going to transpire in East Mission Valley. And I think people were really concerned about it and wanted to see some growth in San Diego State.
You rarely see 70% no on things like this.
Yeah. That's a huge
pushback. That was overwhelming. What's SDSU West, when is that going to get going? Because part of the argument with Soccer City is like, you're not going to see anything from the other people until 10 years from now.
Yeah, I think that was the one issue with Measure G, and that was that its intent, certainly for those of us, I'm a San Diego State faculty, you know, so for me, it ends up being that, you know, the idea of seeing growth and to expand that university, which is much needed, certainly is attractive. I think the problem was that when you look at the plan is sort of still vague. You know, all the details aren't there yet. And so it's kind of like, we're going to take it now, and then we'll figure everything out. It's kind of what Measure G does. And I think people are sort of buying into the fact that, well, even though we don't know all the answers, it's close enough to where we'll embrace this idea. And it's not too far from the other measure. It's just that it incorporates education facilities into that area as well, and along with some business interests as well. And again, there's always some backstory. There's, you know, one of the backers behind Measure G people were concerned about because of his background with the stadium issue and with some other issues down in San Diego. And now he's on the CSU board. So that was a big issue people were concerned about. So the question is the intent, but if you look at both measures, Tweedledee, Tweedledum, I think most people in the city really believe that the city needed to grow, and San Diego State was an avenue to make that happen.
Okay.
Let's talk about city council. Uh-huh. Some big, big changes.
Yeah.
Myrtle Cole getting voted out. Yeah. Lori Zapp also on her way out. Yeah. What are your thoughts and what happened?
Well, it's interesting. Lori Zapp and her district, and it was coming very clear that the demographics were shifting in her district. And so it was becoming a little bit more on the left of center. And so when you look at the numbers, it was happening rather significantly. And so I'm not completely surprised that I thought she still might edge it out, but it was a pretty significant victory. For an incumbent, which is the first time since 1992 to see two of them sitting incumbents to be removed, that's almost 30 years. It's pretty significant.
Yeah, it's a big deal. And Myrtle Cole gets replaced by somebody who used to work for her, used to work on her staff, but decided, maybe I don't like some of the things you've said, some of the things you've done, I'm going to run against you, and she won.
Well, that's also, I think, and again, we'll talk about the national stuff another time, but here's the issue with that. Myrtle Cole tends to be more of a moderate Democrat. You know, and I think over the last couple of decades, the Democrats recognize they need more moderate candidates to run to be able to win elections. Now we're seeing this pushback to people slightly more to the left. And I think that platform is resonating in the Democratic Party, particularly amongst younger Democrats, but also even some of the older ones were saying, we want to go back to what it was, something looks more like we have a party identification, rather than looking like they're milked down in something. So I think what we've seen in this is the fact that the slightly left has moved a little bit more to the left, and that's what's showing in the city council now.
And now Monica Montgomery will take over.
Okay.
Democratic wins a supermajority on the San Diego City Council. What do you see over the next 2 years? What's going to happen?
Well, you know, it's interesting. People always are, you know, the fear mongering happens, right? People think, oh my God, we're going to have this leftist, crazy socialist place, right? Which is not true at all. It's just fear mongering. I think you're going to see, I think people are going to come in. If they're smart, they'll come in, shut their mouths, and learn, watch and learn and see how the game is played first, right? That's what you do politically. But I think it's just going to be a little check and balance on, I think, the overall drive of the city. Yeah. I think most people in politics, if they're doing their job right, do not put party over politics and over the people. So if what the people's needs are being addressed, they're not going to be able to come in with a far left agenda.
Right.
It's just going to be, you know, their philosophy may be to the left, but they're going to be able to have to incorporate that with a city that may be somewhere closer to the middle. And I think these people are, their credibility and their credentials are pretty good. So
well, last thoughts I wanted from you, put yourself in the shoes of Kevin Faulkner right now, our mayor. What's going through his mind this morning with these two new council members?
You know, Kevin, so I mean, I like, you know, he's, I know Kevin, and he's, I like Kevin, you know, as a person, you know, and I think he tends to be more on the moderate side and sensible side. I think he's the kind of person I think anybody can work with. So I think he realizes that, you know, there may be some challenges on some issues, but I also think that he's the kind of person who can work with anybody. And I feel pretty comfortable that, you know, they'll find a way to get things done. He strikes me as that kind of person, and for the time that I've known him, and, you know, I don't see that being a big, you know, there'll be some issues, but I think he's the kind of person who's more of a resolutions kind of person. So
right.
I think it'll be okay. I think
big
it'll be okay.
Big changes coming for San Diego.
But good changes.
Yeah, good changes. Looking forward to see what comes of this. Rick Epps, we thank you as always for your expertise. Thanks
again. Good to see you guys.
All right.